represent the United States at next month's London Olympics. Problem is, only five will be chosen. Most are new faces, but one belongs to Nastia, who 4 years ago won gymnastics' highest Olympic honor. But now she's trying to overcome just how hard it is to return to the Games. 3 weeks ago at the National Championships, she was not ready. Now her last chance to impress Marta Caroli, who has the final say in almost everything at these Olympic trials.
Watching every single movement, and I'm observing how this girl's able to function under the pressure situation. They have to prove that they physically very strong and also to compete when the green light is on. It will be hard. Some people will not make it. You must select five.
Everything from her front row position.
She's the dream maker, but she's also the dream breaker.
This is one tough sport.
Just know we are not alone. Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
I'm very happy with Jordyn. Ollie Reisman always very sturdy. My expectations are high from last year. Gabby Douglas becoming stronger and stronger mentally. The hardest part always is to decide upon the fifth place. Most of these girls were baby girls when I saw them first time. When I have to make the announcement who made the team, I always have to fight my tears back. Unfortunately, somebody will be disappointed.
Sports coverage of the 2012 U.S. Olympic Gymnastics Trials is presented by Chevrolet. Most nights, the HP Pavilion is called the Shark Tank. This weekend, it's a think tank to solve the puzzle of who are the five. We welcome you. The first of two nights of coverage as you look at mckayla. 3 weeks ago, she was a lock to be one of those five. And then while warming up in floor exercise, something horrible and injurious happened to her. She landed flat on her back in the far corner of the mat. She was concussed and suffered a nasal fracture. Immediately, she was taken to the hospital for observation. But before the meet was over, she was back in the arena. And just by returning now to these Olympic trials, she may have shown Marta Caroli all she needs to see.
I'm very pleased with Maroney, how well she came back after her injury in the last competition. She is very determined, very aggressive, mentally totally had no effect.
So we welcome you to NBC Sports coverage of the Olympic trials. mckayla Maroney will begin our coverage on the vault. The drama of her floor exercise will come later. What will happen after 2 days of competition today and Sunday, the all-around champion for just these 2 days of competition will get the one guaranteed spot to the Olympics. After that, it will be solved in a back room here at the HP Pavilion. Tim Daggett, what is she going to show us right off the bat? She's in a hometown situation as a California girl.
Well, she's going to show us what I believe is unquestionably the greatest vault being performed today by a female gymnast. She is the reigning world champion on this vault. And she didn't just win in Tokyo last year at the world. She crushed everybody, and this is huge.
And it's not just the American audience watching this skill right now. It's everyone in the world.
Nobody flies like her. Nobody. I usually try to hold off with the ginormous, but right up to bat. Absolutely phenomenal flight.
So what she is doing in the air overcomes the step.
Absolutely. That was a 3/10 step, but what she does so well is she's got picture-perfect form, and then she just explodes off the tip. Look at the height of her body.
Look at the execution. As Tim said, just that one giant step on the landing, about a 3/10, but that's it. Nothing else.
Could very well be. It's the first piece of gymnastics we saw. I believe it'll be the highest score we'll see all night at the Olympic trials.
And the most important thing is she has done this vault so many times. She has never failed on this vault.
16.1. Only 4/10 deductions, and you'll notice on our scoring. Green is great. Yellow is so-so. And red is not what you want.
And that's super great. 16.1. She was the only one that scored a 16 at the national championships.
To win a medal at the Olympics, you got to do two different balls.
She's going for a stick.
Little bit under-rotated on that.
She could be better on both those balls.
Her coach, Arthur Akopian, a world champion himself for the Soviet Union, one of the greatest vaulters that's ever lived.
And now we go to Rebecca Bross. Uneven bars. She's a six-time world medalist, trying to come back from a horrific knee injury. Look at what surgery has left her on that right knee. It just exploded last year.
It happened on the vault, and most people thought, you know, that with that her Olympic bid was over, but this is one determined kid. Her coach, Larry Lukin, says she is all work. That is what Rebecca Bross is, all work.
And what she is right now is a two-event gymnast. She'll only be performing on uneven bars, her specialty, as well as balance beam, but as Marta Caroli told us, she has to be awesome.
And this is pretty darn good. She's a world medalist on the uneven bars. Placed as high as second in the all-around at Worlds. But injuries as of late have really done some damage for her Olympic dream.
Not over yet.
There's her coach, Valeri Lukin. They'll have another prize pupil, his daughter, a little bit later on the uneven bars.
Great job, man.
And we go to Needham, Massachusetts, Allie Raisman. She's one of the core members.
Allie has been so consistent throughout this year of competition, and I'll tell you what, Marta Caroli loves her. She loves her mental toughness. She can compete.
Same ball. We saw for mckayla. Good. Very difficult ball. This has a maximum score of a 16.5, the same as we saw from mckayla Maroney. But this one does not have the same amplitude, the same flight off of the table and in the air. Her knees are a little bit bent.
And Allie knows it. She told us, I want to be one of the top three in team finals in London performing this vault. I want to make it count. She's been working on the form in the air and, of course, the landing.
You see the knees, though, and a little bit under-rotated on that twist. Not enough to get it devalued, but
you got it.
It's a good start for her. This is what Allie Raisman will do all day long. She will just keep on hitting routines and let other people mess up. That's how she's going to make the Olympic team. I believe she will.
Kyla is Kyla Ross, and these trials are crucial for her.
She is a first-year senior, and she is actually an all-around gymnast that Marta Caroli always talks about. Ask about Gabby, ask about Jordyn, and she always wants to talk about Kyla. She says that she has the international look that the judges around the world, they crave this look. Long, lean, clean lines.
Raisman gets a 15.55 on the board.
And what better way for Kyla to show this off on uneven bars? You're going to see these beautiful handstand positions that the judges are looking for. But, you know, she's a first-year senior, but I want to mention that in the junior year, her resume of international competitions, unbelievable. Very, very successful as a junior.
Rebecca Bross, it's a green. It's good. 15.3 on the uneven bars.
Now on uneven bars, Kyla Bross.
She told us right before the meet, all I gotta do is just compete like I train.
Just don't hold back.
This is her biggest skill in the routine. Right here, flies. Very nicely done. A little bit of a leg separation, but... And we're going to say this throughout the competition. If the USA has a weakness, it's on the uneven bars. And being that Kyla Ross is one of the top workers in the U.S. on uneven bars, with her sturdy all-around performance and being great here, that is a wonderful recipe to become an Olympian.
Elfie, is that about as good as she can do it?
That is as good as she could have performed that routine. She has been so consistent. I'm not surprised.
That's a big routine. It's so big because, once again, we're going to say it all night long. If they have a weakness, it's on uneven bars, and she delivered.
About 10 feet in front of us is Alicia Sacramone. At the World Championships last year, just before things got started in Tokyo, she came down, and the landing was awful. Her Achilles tendon popped, they told her, 8 months. And that's about exactly what it was to get ready for the Nationals. And with the Olympic rings tattooed on the back of her neck, here she goes to show Marta Caroli that she can add a specialty to Team USA.
And she's great here. She is phenomenal. A world champion herself. Different ball. She'll hit it forwards. Actually, a lot better. More power than she had at the national championships a few weeks ago. But once again, she didn't just have one movement on the landing. She had two complete different movements, but she explodes off the table. 1.5 twist. Now watch the landing. Slides and then moves that second step. If she had brought it forward, they could have called it only one.
And we have to remember that on this particular event, the U.S. is very strong. There are many women performing this end marvel with a 6.5.
We can tell you that Kyla Ross received a 15.5 on the uneven bars. As we send you over to the on the uneven bars, the woman who was competing at home at those national championships in St. Louis, Missouri, 15-year-old Sarah Finnegan. Sacramone, 15.7, nicely done with her first ball. Where does she fit into this puzzle we're talking about?
Well, she is a great all-around gymnast. She's a little bit inexperienced, to be honest. She shines, though. Floor exercise and balance beam does one of the most difficult beam routines in the world. But remember, the USA has got a lot of great beam workers, and they're pretty darn good on floor as well. Where they need to shore up a routine is on the unevens.
Now, this might not be Sarah's best apparatus, but what she'll do is beautiful execution in all her work. She's a young athlete. This is a huge, huge experience for her competing in this arena.
One of the criticisms, she's supposed to fly high on her releases and sometimes doesn't get the amplitude that the judges require. Let's watch this one right here. Not bad, but probably a tenth for not showing flight, enough flight in the air.
But those legs are just squeezed together, glued tight, toes pointed, just the dismount.
Besides the little hop on the landing, as good as she can do, but that is not going to bring in a competitive routine at the top for Team USA.
Remember, as you listen to Tim and Elfie break down these routines, it's important to remember the judges don't add. All they do is subtract. To vault. And Elizabeth Price, coached by a couple of legends, Bill and Donna Strauss from Pennsylvania.
Now on vault, Elizabeth.
If you asked people a year ago, would Elizabeth Price even be at the Olympic trials, they would have said no. But she has had such an amazing year, and predominantly her worth to the team could come here as well. She is powerful. Big, big vault.
I believe you called that the second best Aminar in the world. Elizabeth was touched by that comment, by the way, at Classics.
That was big.
Nastia Lukin about to mount the uneven bars, trying to get a return trip to the Olympic Games. 3 weeks ago, she wasn't close.
No, this was actually the first day of competition, and right off the bat, watch, she is going to hit her feet on the bars right there. That's a 5/10 deduction. It kind of freaks you out a little bit.
Messes up the rhythm.
That was beautiful.
And remember, at this point, we had not watched Nastia do a full bar routine in practice.
But right here, she comes too close to the bar on this. This is a very big error. She has to totally change her routine. She's adding elements right there, and it was exhausting. She couldn't even do a dismount.
And now live 3 weeks later, she probably has a pretty good idea, as her dad watches, how this is going to go.
Well, we've actually watched her do some bar routines from start to finish. Mind you, Valeri was always close by, giving a little tap here and there.
Definitely had her struggles in warm-ups as well. She's going to do three spins in a row on this one arm. Fantastic. Now here is where it all went bad. Adviza's perfect.
She's tired at this point, just the design.
And this is hard for her.
Oh, dear.
Is that an endurance thing?
It was definitely endurance. You know, I mean, the routine was as close to flawless as she's been able to prove in this comeback. But right at the end, she was a little bit over on a handstand, adjusted with her knees. That's a 5/10 point deduction. And then when something like that happens, your brain, it's on hyperdrive. She knows that the dismount isn't easy. But I'll tell you, with that fall right there and what she did at the Visa Championships, I don't know if it's possible for Nastia Lukin.
An unreal segue to the new It Girl, Jordyn Weaver, world champion, national champion.
She has won every practice in this arena right up until here.
Not bad.
She has been on fire.
So many things unfolding here in San Jose, California. Marta Crowley missing nothing. On the other side of the break, live coverage in the rubber match between Michael Phelps and Ryan Lochte in Omaha, Nebraska at the swimming Olympic trials. Dan Hicks and Rowdy Gaines will have so many exciting things to talk about in London, as will we. Will Nastia Lukin be part of that? Certainly things take a big hit here with that bad finish to the uneven bars. That's a big-time red number. 14.05 with almost 2.5 points of deductions.
You know, what went wrong in this routine is she just isn't in good enough shape. She cast to a handstand. She's a little bit over here.
Using a lot of energy here.
Bends her knees, which is a huge deduction right there. And her mind is going, like I said, at warp speed right now, trying to get it back together. She kind of doesn't even go for the dismount. That wasn't what she was supposed to do. She was supposed to do an extra half turn, but
she's moved on. Jordyn Weaver, 15.9. The numbers go up, and she is peaking at just the right time, isn't she?
Oh, God, that is a huge number for her. A couple tenths higher than she got averaged at the Visa Championships.
And just physically, overall, throughout the workouts, we've watched her get a little bit better each day. And this has been her plan. This was the game plan.
So two stories that feel like they're headed in opposite directions here. Nastia Lukin's gymnastics career can go up against anyone who's ever performed, and yet it's, how is she today?
Yeah, I mean, what she did is just devastating for her Olympic dream to come true again for a second time. You know, she said she'd already crossed out all of her personal goals. It was only about if she could she help Team USA to win that gold medal in London.
That is the one gold medal she doesn't have. Team gold medal, uneven bars gold medal.
If Gabby Douglas had a logo, I think it should be a rocket ship. That is what she has been this year, and she has given Jordyn Weber all she can handle at the top of the major competitions that the both have entered.
She said if it goes well for her this weekend, after the second day, she might show us her happy dance out on the floor.
And you know, if it does go well for her, this is amazing to say, because Jordyn Weber looks better than ever. She's the reigning world all-around champion. If it goes perfect for this young girl right here, I think she can end up winning.
She had a major fall on the balance beam at the national championships and lost by 0.2. Had an unbelievable comeback.
Liang Chow, her coach, of course, the coach of Sean Johnson, Olympic gold medalist on the balance beam.
And that was one of the reasons why Gabby chose this gym. She said it was because of Sean Johnson. She loved the way Sean would execute, land her skills. She said she was perfection, and that was the club that she felt, and this coach, who could take her to the Olympic Games.
If you've been watching the sport long enough, you see the same coaches. That's because they've got that touch. They've got the ability to mold these gymnasts. Of course, in Beijing, Sean Johnson gave Liang Chow the honor of returning to his native country as a coach of a medal challenger. It was a great story.
And what a nice, incredibly honorable man. But I tell you right now, she's lifting her arms and she is doing something she's never done before, Al. She is competing in the Olympic trials, and no matter how experienced, how good you are, you never know how it's going to feel until right now.
Oh.
A little struggle. A little bit of a struggle, but Gabby is so great on the uneven bars.
What a fighter.
Yeah, it's still going to get a good score.
Her once teammate, Sean Johnson, looking on. A little bit nervy, I think, to be perfectly honest.
That's been one of the areas for Gabby Douglas, is her focus.
Sean Johnson received one of the loudest ovations when she was shown on the scoreboard, and she knows exactly what Gabby's going through.
You could see her right arm a little bit shaky there, not hitting those handstand positions, and right here is where she muscled this move, but boy, what a fighter. This may be her first Olympic trials, but that's going to take her a long way, that experience of what she did right there.
And Sean knows it. As does this lady, Marta Caroli.
Marta wanted to see Gabby improve as the stage got brighter. Doesn't get much bigger than this, but at the national championships, as we just said, she fought almost all the way back. We move to a new rotation in San Jose. Go to NBCOlympics.com for exclusive photos and more of your favorite gymnasts. Go to NBCOlympics.com to learn more. Back in San Jose, imagine the crushing feeling of having to withdraw on the first day of the Olympic trials. Such is the story of Bridget Sloan. For more, here's Andrea Joyce.
Al, it was just a couple of hours ago. Bridget was warming up on the uneven bars, missed a release move, and injured her left elbow. Dr. Larry Nassar told me it looks like it's a sprain, but they did take her to the hospital for an MRI just to be sure. Bottom line is she can't put any weight on it, and it would be way too dangerous for her to try to do any gymnastics at all. I spoke to Bridget before she left for the hospital. She is obviously devastated by this turn of events. You know, this comeback has not been easy for her. She's had more than her share of injuries the last couple of years. Already a little philosophical, though, telling me that mentally she will never, ever give up. Never give up that fight. But physically, her body is clearly sending her a message, one she cannot ignore. And you know what kind of teammate she is, Al. Won't surprise you to know she's going to come back after the hospital to cheer on all of these other gymnasts. Al.
Okay. sad story for the former world champion. Here's Allie Raisman, obviously, on the uneven bars.
And this is not her strongest. She actually gets her two weakest events, vault and uneven bars, out of the way. This is the weaker of those two. Has lots of little form breaks.
But she still wants to show Marta that she could count on her. You never know what happens at the Olympic Games. For the past 2 weeks, she's been in that gym doing more bar routines than ever before. She said it's been hard for her, but she wants to be in top shape.
And that was good for her. Very good. You know, it had the same exact little places where she loses tense for form, her feet, her knees a little bit. But like I said at the top, this is what Allie is going to do to you all day long.
To Kyla Ross, who was so good on the uneven bars to start her night.
And this is an event where, once again, the reason why Marta loves this gymnast so much is because of her lines. She shows great flexibility. She's typically very calm. She's appeared that way all week long. And she has top skills.
That right there, though, was supposed to connect into an element. She won't get a deduction. She just won't get an extra tenth of a point.
Much of what this event has become are these acrobatic skills, like right here, combinations, back to back. You can't afford to take too much of a pause in between, or you won't get the connection value. Little bit shaky.
Yeah, up until that point, though, she has really looked very calm and very aggressive. When you have those nerves, the first thing that gets thrown out the window is aggressive gymnastics. And when you lose your aggression, it is so easy.
Yeah, right there, Tim, she lost the connection. Those two skills were supposed to be back to back. And that's crucial. They'll show up in the score.
But that's crucial, too. I'd have to say that she's one of the best stickers on the floor. She's going to be a little bit upset with that, but that's about it as she gets some words of advice from one of her coaches, Jenny Zhang. They have been together for so long. Been on this journey, really, to impress that selection committee.
Right, and right about now, Marta's thinking, okay, needs to be a little bit better in some of the areas where it needs to improve are combinations like this. That was done beautifully, the aerial side cartwheel, but connections like this. Not bad here, but there were other areas in her routine where there was just too much time taken. And I'll tell you what, at the Olympic Games, they will put that pen down to paper and say tick, tick, tick.
But right there, gymnastics 101, just a perfect landing. That's the last thing the judges see. That's the last thing they remember. That has an impact.
The atmosphere in this building tonight is really special. Allie Raisman, 14.2 on the uneven bars.
I feel like the podium,
Now Sarah Finnegan on the balance beam.
And we saw her earlier on the uneven bars where we said it's not her best event. Well, this can be just mind-blowing good.
Yeah, it has the potential to score very, very high. She has amazing acrobatic skills, but what I love about this athlete, as young as she is, she has already mastered the art of artistry on the balance beam. Check out this mount. It is by far my most favorite skill coming up right here.
Just give that a try on the banister at home. See how it goes.
The This is her long acrobatic skill. It'll take the entire length of the beam. Had some trouble in workouts, but
fantastic.
Spot on. Oops.
Has the ability to score as high as a 16.9. If she gets all of her connections, I think she's missed one of them at this point, so. There we go, dismount.
She just needs a little bit more time.
Elfie, how does gymnastics award innovation like that move she did early on?
Well, she is by far one of the most innovative athletes on this event. I have a lot of respect for someone that takes great risk in a skill like that. Sadly, it doesn't get as much as it deserves, in my opinion. I think it's incredibly difficult. She takes the risk, whereas many athletes in the world are just jumping up on the balance beam. This is a skill you will remember. You'll associate it with Sarah Finnegan. You say, oh yeah, that's the girl that does that really cool mount. You want it to be memorable.
To Jordyn Weaver in third after the first rotation.
Now on the even bars, Jordyn Weaver.
Nastia Lukin getting set to go on the balance beam.
And if there is a place where Jordyn has a slight weakness, it's on the uneven bars. So we call it a slight weakness, right? Well, right there, she has to use a little bit of muscle. And this is tricky for her, right? This handstand right here, but that was great. And like I said, has a slight weakness. She made the world championship finals on this event. Gets a hug from Coach John Gettard.
Those stuck landings can be the difference.
And not just that, Al. She actually added a full twist to that double layout from what we saw her at the Visa Championships, which increases her potential maximum score.
Nastia Lukin. Can she shake off what happened just a few minutes ago?
Well, she may be able to get through this routine, but can she shake off what happened a couple of minutes ago? No, it's absolutely impossible. I think she's concentrating on beam right now, but deep down, you know, she knows that the only way she earns her ticket is really through uneven bars, and she has only one more opportunity.
What Nastia does so well, of course, is the artistry, her execution. You'll see top scores if this is a stuck event for her.
Full turn sequence. I saw her practice that about 10 times in a row the other day. Coach and Dad Valeri was not happy even once.
Given her some heartache throughout the week. It's a very difficult skill where she loses sight of the beam, but unfortunately, it's one of her key skills.
And she's got to hurry here, though. We've already gotten the bell.
Unfortunately, without the uneven bars, this doesn't really matter.
You know, the USA has so many great balance beam workers, and she's kind of middle of the pack on beam, even when she hits. She knows she gets that ticket to London with bars, and it was a disaster on bars.
She knew how much history she was battling when she attempted this comeback.
So difficult, and like we've said, we have seen her, not just here, all week long here, all week at the national championships, she struggled on that.
Jordyn Weber, 15.35. Kyla Ross balance beam, 14.6. We'll get Nastia Lukin's score after this.
Most of you know Jordyn Weber as a world champion. I know her as something different.
This is our first clip of you, Jordyn.
Oh my God.
Get used to it.
To her friends, she's not a world champion. She's just Jordyn. Even though a lot of people know who she is, she doesn't like it when I film her in her off time.
This is Jordyn Weber in her pink bedroom.
It's so messy right now.
You have anything to say?
Beautiful outside today.
She's worked very hard to get where she is, and I'm very proud of her. And I can't wait for London. No matter what happens, she'll still be my little sister.
That is Ryan, who's a football player, channeling his inner Marty Scorsese.
Very cute.
I love the stop.
And I mean it.
Every sister's experienced that with a brother.
We continue now with Mckayla Maroney. First after the first rotation on the uneven bars.
Has beautiful lines. Excellent toe point. Hasn't been as consistent on this event as some of her others, but has shown some improvement, but that right there, that's a full point. She'll lose the element as well. It's about a point and a half off.
I was going to say, after Visa Championships and her injury, she's really only had 1 week of practice where she's been able to do full routines. Not a lot of time.
Tell you though, she had looked great in training. She started fantastic on her first event, the vault, her signature event.
Well, Tim, how is Marta going to make her decisions? Based upon these Olympic trials or based upon these and other observations and impressions?
These and others. The one top all-around gymnast from the 2 days of trials. They are a lock. They will be named to the Olympic team for London. The rest of the four will be decided by a selection committee. Marta Caroli, Steve Rybecki, and the athlete rep Taryn Humphrey will go back and plug in a lot of different numbers. They'll look at just everything, and they'll remember this right there. Those hands didn't get that bar. And, you know, they wouldn't imagine they'd have to use Mckayla in a team final on bars, but they're not going to like that.
Two beam and Sabrina Vager. Carmel, New York. Where does she fit in?
Well, what she is so good at is this event right here. She says that Marta Caroli has, you know, for the last number of years called her a beamer because she's so stable on this event.
And no wonder her coach, Teodora Ungureanu, who we all know was the lead-up athlete for Nadia at the 1976 Olympic Games. She always set Nadia up, and Romanians have always traditionally been known for their fine beam work. But this is what has plagued Sabrina since the World Championships. She has really not been at the top of her game, for sure.
You know, both at the Nationals and then here at the trials, she has just not looked anywhere near as confident. Started on uneven bars. We didn't see that, but she really struggled.
Her highlight of her career, of course, was being a member of that gold medal winning team at the World Championships last year, something she is extremely proud of.
She's
She says the wait has been long. She feels like she has waited her entire life for this moment, competing at the Olympic trials in the hopes of making this team.
And I talked to her coach, Teodora, before the competition, and she said, I don't know, somebody's filling her head saying that she can make the Olympic team. Our goal is just to be an alternate. And if we do that, we can hug, be happy. If we don't, we'll cry together.
So Sabrina exits, and Jordyn Weber has a smile and a well-deserved one. She's looking to clinch that one spot to the Olympics in these 2 days of competition. Family camp by P&G, doing some great work with moms, and there is Natalie Hawkins, Gabby Douglas's mom, and a lot of the parents agonized through this whole process, but she looks pretty calm right there. And her daughter, 16-year-old Gabrielle, is in the middle of this Olympic story.
Actually, I ran into her mom this morning getting coffee, and she said she is petrified. She said she's never experienced anything like it at all. And you see that top she's wearing? They had cool Gabby shirts on, all of them dressed together. They said they were going more elegant tonight. They were going to wear colors that bring out the color of Gabby's leotard. So you didn't know that. Now, did you, Al?
That's why you're here too.
Lovely. But when we spoke with that, Gabby just a couple of days ago, she said, I'm so confident. I mean, she came on so strong with us in our interview. She said, I am hungry for this. I can't wait to get this started.
Here's some drama at the Visa Championships in St. Louis, Missouri, 3 weeks ago. Gabby Douglas on the balance beam. Everything is fine, and then all of a sudden, it's not.
Gabby said she was so mad at herself after falling off the scale, she just wanted to kick a chair.
Well, what she did was channel that into some fantastic gymnastics. She came all the way back, shook it off as if it never happened, and missed winning a national championship by 0.2 of a point to Jordyn Weber.
And believe it or not, that skill that she fell on at the national championship, she calls that her easy stuff. And she said that's what she's been doing the last couple of weeks, is really focusing on the easy stuff in her routine, paying extra attention to those skills.
And I tell you, it was just a riot meeting with her family, because her mom was saying, oh, it's so exciting. It's such an honor just to be here. And her sister, Gabby's sister, Ariel, is going, say thank you, Mom. Say thank you. And I'm going, what's going on here? She goes, say thank you, say thank you. And I'm, well, what's this? And she goes, well, for 4 years, Ariel begged me to put Gabby into gymnastics. I finally broke down. So that's why we're all here, is because of the sis. Where she had the problem. Oh boy.
And again, connections. That was fine, but the skill before, she didn't connect it.
Big skill.
Always solid on that one.
And it's ridiculous because it's so much harder than that other combination. Sometimes, you know, things get in your head and it's just so hard to make them go away.
Final bit of gymnastics, the dismount.
The family will take that one. Although she knows she can do actually quite a bit better than that.
Right here.
Thank you.
gets a proud smile.
She's just glad she stayed on that beam. But in order to get the big score, you have to connect your skills, because she's counting on these connections. These are valuable tenths, and she won't get it there with that slight bobble that was supposed to keep going into the acrobatic skill.
Doesn't quite get as much height as she would want to on this, but the landing, very good.
Is that a stuck landing or not?
It's not. No, she definitely slid her feet. It should be a tenth of a point off.
Mom watching all the way to the end. That's relief.
Okay.
We'll get Gabby's score in just a moment. Rebecca Bross is going to try and keep her good night going.
Yeah, and this is the only other event we'll see Rebecca on. She has become a specialist on even bars, where she could fill a void for the American team, or right here on balance beam, where she's been great in the past. The one area that gives her such grief is this dismount. She continues to do it time and time again. It's a big one. It's one of the most difficult dismounts in the world, and she has struggled with it.
Gabby Douglas gets a 14.9 on the balance beam.
It's actually a little bit harsher. She had an execution score of 8.7, 1.3 off in deductions. Well, Rebecca really was great on bars. Here's her first test. It's a blind landing skill.
Can't hold it.
And that is significant. That's a big fall.
Yeah, so, you know, because she did do a good job on bars, you know, and that's where Team USA needs some help. But she has to show she can be reliable in more than one place. And I'll tell you, that fall on beam, that is not going to help her in any way, even be part of the conversation. This point with the fall and then the rough routine, she has that dismount that has been not just hard for her but scary for her. And
the warning bell has already gone off, but she needs to take a moment here to set herself up.
Big test. She's over time.
Oh, gosh. Oh dear.
Somehow that surgically repaired knee holds together. You know, Tim, there should be a retirement ritual, a ceremony. Every female gymnast should have some time alone with a chainsaw and the balance beam. That's the end of the rotation. The gymnasts at the U.S. Olympic Trials move on. Jordyn Weber looking rock solid to earn that one top spot, that guaranteed trip to London. Getting set to mount the balance beam, always a daunting proposition, but you see her on the balance beam in London, correct?
Absolutely. You know, if you took the average from the national championships, she was far away the highest score, averaged a 15.325. The next closest competitor was a 15.2.
She could be the team leader. Allie said she surpassed her goals at national championships. You know, she had never been a national champion. She is on balance beam, as well as floor exercise. But more importantly, she told me here at these trials, she wants to prove to Marta that wasn't a fluke. I should be on balance beam as one of the counting routines.
Mm-hmm.
very unusual for Allie. It's not going to be a huge deduction, but obviously, if you can see an error at home, the judges can see it, believe me. Just so tough, and I'll tell you, her toughness alone and the ability that she has to make Marta relax a little bit, that alone, I can't imagine a team without her on.
Big dismount. Wow.
Awesome.
That's why Marta wants her on this team, to add some calmness, some focus, confidence. She has it all.
Coach Mihai Breskin gives a hug and has to jump up to the podium quickly to help ready his next pupil, 2008 Olympian, Alicia Sacramone.
And this looks a little bit different than Gabby Douglas's mom.
It's painful being up there in the stands watching.
Well, remember, Nastia Lukin, her mom, couldn't watch at all.
She'd walk out of the building.
What about you as a dad with Peter?
It's horrific. I'm usually lifting him to the ring, so I kind of have to look, but I wish I didn't.
And Mihai, back-to-back Olympics with a gymnast that shows you he's got that touch. Back to Sarah Finnegan.
And you know, what she needs to do is put on a show right now. It is clear that Sarah is inexperienced. She has a long way to go. She could go to the next Olympic Games. She just needs to give us a show because this is her specialty.
She just didn't have anywhere near enough rotation at the end of her back one and a half. That was disappointing.
Steve right back here on the left with Mark Rowley. Everything they see, you can almost hear the sentence. Well, what do you think? Does that change anything?
Oh, yeah, that changes a lot right there. And, you know, there have been more falls from the top athletes than Marta wants to see. 14.95, and it's, see that yellow, over 1.2 in deductions. And I have to say that I'm surprised by that score. I think that at these trials, they're being far more critical than they were at the national championships on beam. Started on vault and was great. Is this like Rebecca Bross and Nastia Lukin? She is a two-event specialist. So there's an area where a connection was possible and will not be given, but you know, all those adjustments of the body, each one get added together for the deductions. She said her Achilles tendon doesn't bother her at all. She says everything else does, though, even my fingers. No idea why my fingers hurt, but they do.
Well, and that's one of the reasons Marta has to think long and hard about her decision, especially with a veteran such as Alicia, who has had these injuries because it has plagued the U.S. before at Olympic Games. This is a very difficult dismount for Alicia. She's tired.
Watch how she lands with one foot in front of the other here, though. Well, it's very good dismount.
You're done for today. Good job.
She says her Achilles doesn't bother her, but she always lands with that taped ankle in front of the other one, takes the bulk of the landing on the unaffected ankle.
So has she helped herself out or not?
That was just baseline. You know, she helped herself out on vaulting, but that was definitely just okay.
A lot of tension in the room here in San Jose as the 2012 U.S. Olympic team trials continues here on NBC Sports. A lot of people who lived it in 1996 think that Terry Strug on a bad ankle hitting the vault and then being carried with that injured foot by Bella Caroli is one of those great moments. And he's also, of course, attached to Mary Lou Retton. And Bella Caroli is here supporting his wife Marta as she guides Team USA.
Yeah, nobody's done as much as Bella Caroli in the sport of gymnastics. Certainly on the women's side, he has been around since Nadia Comaneci scored a perfect 10 in the 1976 Olympic Games and became a world phenom. Came to the United States and has had so many individual champions.
Nadia was the last all-around gold medalist to return to the Olympics, underscoring how hard it is to do what Nastia Lukin tried to do here. Sabrina Vega, floor exercise. By the way, Alicia Sacramone got a 15.0 balance beam.
Very big number there.
They've been so costly, and it's just not enough. It will not impress Marta.
No, but you know, I think she actually was a lot more relaxed in that exercise, and you saw a little bit of her personality.
Well, it's okay. You need to control it, but with much better effort than before. Good.
Yeah, I agree, Teodora.
Now Jordyn Weaver on the balance beam. She's the leader.
She said what she did leaving St. Louis and winning the national championship title was just go back to the gym
and focus on those really tiny details, things like stuck landings on dismounts. This is one of the events that I've noticed it on all week long. She has done amazingly well on her dismount.
And she's getting everybody used to what she looks like wearing the colors and the uniform of Team USA.
That was a nice connection.
This is very difficult right here. She pauses too long to get that connection. And I would say pauses too long to get that one as well, but very difficult.
Better job on those two skills than she had done at the Visa Championships. This has been what her whole week has looked like. Strong, effortless, so confident each and every day. I said she won the workouts. Your eyes were just automatically drawn to her routines every day.
Dismount, she'll do a laid out back somersault. She'll do 2.5 twists. Been so close to sticking.
Oh, see how close that is. It is obvious how hard she has worked since championships. She has just gotten better and better.
John Gettard and his wife, Catherine, have coached this young lady for so many years, it's even hard to count. Beautiful dismount. She does this so well.
She's looking beyond these trials. She's looking towards London and what it's going to take to win an all-around gold medal. Dismounts like that.
Many people, if they had that angle when they were landing, would have panicked.
Brother Ryan.
She's just completely unaffected. That's what it comes down to.
And Gabby Douglas floor exercise.
And this really can be a great routine for you.
We have not seen a lot of high scores tonight.
No. Nope.
Too. Good job.
in London next month. By the way, Jordyn Weaver, 15.05. She survives the balance beam and probably still holds the lead. Kyla Ross would love to do what Gabby Douglas just did on floor exercise, and that is get the highest score of the night so far with a 15.45.
9 tenths higher than anybody else so far.
Herself a very good night. The 2012 U.S. Olympic team trials, night one, continues in a moment. Jordyn Weaver has the lead. Getting set for the fourth and final rotation, Jordyn Weaver leads the way, and that's important because the leader after Sunday's competition is guaranteed a spot in the Olympics. After that, four spots chosen by Marta Caroli and the selection committee. We go to Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel at what we're calling the London board. Tim, what do you think has been established so far as that team?
Well, I think you still have the same four core great all-around gymnasts. You have Jordyn Weaver. She's the reigning all-around champion. Gabby Douglas, Allie Raceman, and I still think Kyla Ross is in there because she's so valuable. She's got that international look.
So, Elfie, with that extra gymnast, the fifth, where could the team pick up a few extra tenths?
Well, before the competition started, I was going to pick up this name, Nastia Lukin. I was going to select her right up here on her specialty, but I can't do that. Not after today's performance. I'm actually going to put Nastia back down and stick with this plan.
So, Tim, where's another hole?
Well, another hole is definitely on vaulting, and I'll tell you, Mckayla Maroney, she's the reigning world champion. She could add up to 8 tenths of a point on one event only, so she could take Allie Raceman's place. But she was great on vaulting, and she's fallen 2 times on both the uneven bars and the balance beams. And so that gives us a gymnast like Elizabeth Price. She had a phenomenal vault as well. So if Maroney has a bad day on day two, we could see Elizabeth Price.
It's a bad news day for the returning Olympians, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, Alan. You know, I know, unfortunately, personally, that there is nothing harder than trying to get back to a second Olympic Games.
I can tell you that when we discussed the London board before the broadcast tonight, Elizabeth Price's name was not in the conversation. It is now. And we will continue live in San Jose, California, to see how she handles being part of that. On night one of the 2012 U.S. Olympic team trials for the women. Things will all be decided by Sunday. When Elizabeth Price was asked, what are her goals in gymnastics? She said, make the national team and be named to the Pan American Games. Well, now, maybe things have changed. because she is part of the conversation right now. Coached by a couple of legends. I first met Bill and Donna Strauss in 1982, and they were already established with the Parkettes in Allentown, Pennsylvania.
Such wonderful people, and, you know, they've had their share of great athletes. Kristen Maloney hopes by the Olympians. They've also been on the other side of the coin with Kim Kelly being taken off.
Championships, she finished fifth in the all-around, and that's the magic number.
She smiled after every tumbling pass.
Joe Stallone, another coach at Parkettes, Donna Strauss. Like I said, they have experienced the absolute highs and the devastating lows. Keep a camera on that big guy, Bill. He's probably got tears in his eyes right now, if I know him.
Oh, look at that.
Yep. A lot of great moments for this man. Look at that. Oh.
Day for Elizabeth Price. And
she says her coaches have taught her, they have pushed her in the gym, and they have said, you always, whatever happens, you follow your dreams. She might be realizing a pretty big dream in about a month's time.
Well, what it comes down to is really she's kind of in the same boat as Mckayla Maroney, because the USA wants a huge vault like Mckayla has, but they also probably need another great floor score, and they just need a steady all-around gymnast. And today she's delivered big on vault. She has not fallen anywhere, and she gets another green arrow, 14.9.
Now, green is not something that is connected with this competition. That is something we've generated to help it along as far as understanding what a score is, because all the apparatus just are not scored the same. Now, Jordyn Weaver.
Well, what I'm expecting. In case you can't hear me, I'm way up here. I'm expecting big smiles. Watch those eyes as she focuses on the audience and the judges.
Come on, guys.
not see the yellow flag rise, the judges have to signal that for it to be a deduction.
Countdown to the London Olympic Games continues on NBC as Danil Leyva and John Orozco, center screen in the blue shirt, compete at the U.S. Olympic Gymnastics Trials. Tomorrow beginning live at 4 p.m. Eastern Time right here on NBC Sports. And we will have the announcement of the men's team on Sunday in our women's competition. The women's announcement will come as part of our live coverage from here in the HP Pavilion. John Orozco, the national champion. Great to see him come out. I can tell you, Jordan, 15.4. And Gabby Douglas now needs better 16.1 to the lead from Weaver. What's her value here?
16.5. 16.1 is what Mckayla Maroney scored on ball, the highest score of the night. Gabby has been close to a 16 before. She's going to have to be exactly perfect. She's capable. It could happen.
This is just like the finish to the Nationals.
Yes, it could happen. She's got to stick the landing, though.
It's been a bit of a roller coaster ride for this young lady on this vault. It's hot or cold.
It's a very good vault. She just takes a very small step, and that's what's critical. The judges on the floor, they're going to have to decide whether or not that was wider than shoulder width apart. If it's wider, it's a 3/10 deduction. If it's less, it's a 1/10. I think it was a 1/10 deduction.
Get your tape measures out.
So you got the 16.5, right? So you definitely have a 16.4 with that 1/10 deduction, or
thanks, pal, you got it.
You got a little bit of knees in the air and just a slight little step forward. It's gonna be close. I don't think she's gonna get all the way there, but it is going to be close.
It's odd because the judges sit on the side and yet they're being asked to judge lateral movement. Gabby Douglas is just going to miss, but that's going to make Sunday very interesting. A 50.8 back to Mckayla Maroney. She has to shake off a fall on the balance beam that happened in her last rotation. And on the floor exercise warming up. Oh, so hard to watch. That was 3 weeks ago.
Well, that happened directly in front of us. I saw this and I just jumped out of my seat.
Concussion, nasal fracture, and back to go for it.
Was cleared a week ago Monday to start gymnastics. She said she was still in the gym though, stretching, conditioning, and doing mental routines, routine after routine.
Did she keep that routine that led to the injury in it?
Exactly. It'll happen right here.
she gets right back up on the horse and maybe can ride it right across the pond.
And boy, did she ever need that. She was great on her first event, fell on the second two. This is an event, though, that potentially she would have to do in the team finals. She did it in team finals at the World Championships just about 9 months ago.
Huge score for Gabby Douglas. She misses taking over the lead by just 0.3. Nobody will catch Jordyn Weaver, and she's going to head into Sunday's competition as the leader. And again, we say it because every sport, even men's and women's gymnastics, is different. Just the one top spot is the guaranteed spot in the Olympics.
She's doing a harder ball. Her coach couldn't wait to tell me.
She was having trouble in workout at championships, and it was Marta Foley that told them, don't do it. Don't take a chance. She'd look better in workouts on that ball.
Yeah, she made a whole bunch of them.
That surprised me.
She was a little bit slow on the table. Just didn't get enough bounce and lost a little rotation. A little slow right there. Her body is not flipping fast enough, and she's really not even close to getting that around.
Oh, we saw much better vaults from her in workout. I'm really surprised. That's disappointing.
It's all right. It's okay.
Thanks, Allie Raisman. Final rotation again. Nothing will be determined tonight.
And this floor routine, I believe, it has the highest maximum score that's being done in the world today. She can score 16.5, and that, wow! A very big number.
A big favor there. Yeah, this tumbling is out of this world. She gets such height. Check out this first tumbling pass, one of the hardest ones in the world. She packs it in. Back up the yellow flag.
Everybody's had their hiccups tonight, huh?
She should give herself a hand, because one more night like that and she is unquestionably an Olympian.
So Jordyn Weaver is the leader going into Sunday, the final day, and she is with Andrea Joyce.
Al, everybody talks about peaking at the right time. Elfie just said that you look like you are ready to go to London. Is that the sense you have?
Definitely. I've been working so hard to try to improve at every competition, and I think I've improved a lot since Visa, so I'm happy to come out and hit four stronger teams.
You always talk about being in the moment and the importance of that, but how difficult is that as you inch your way to that announcement on Sunday?
It's difficult. You know, I have to stay focused and still just take it one step at a time, one routine at a time.
It'll be a long 48 hours.
Yeah, definitely.
Good luck. Congratulations. Al?
Tomorrow, the NBC Sports Network begins coverage of the Tour de France, cycling's most prestigious event. Don't miss the Tour de France tomorrow on the NBC Sports Network. Later, the countdown to the London Olympic Games continues. continues on NBC as Danelle Leyva and John Orozco compete at the U.S. Olympic Gymnastics Trials, the final day tomorrow live at 4 Eastern on NBC Sports. Coming up next, except on the West Coast, it's your local news, followed by an all-new Tonight Show with Jay Leno at 11:30, 10:30 Central. One thing was confirmed, Jordyn Weaver is number one in America, and reaffirmed was the status right behind her for Gabby Douglas. For Elfie Schlegel, Tim Daggett, and Andrea Joyce, I'm Al Trower. Good night from San Jose.